I used to do fashion photographies mainly in Paris, but I used to travel in New York or Milan and Spain, and of course London. I've been driving a lot in the US when I used to do pictures, and Arizona is a place, strangely, the only place that in everywhere I've been that I can find that we can stay and we can be something, reinvent, be challenged again. This is the only place. We open Merci because my dreams is to bring something like in Paris, a simple place where people can reach, go and have a good time. We just want to share with the people everything that we appreciate the most. In the United States, we have such amazing like beef, like incredibly amazing beef. I turned the ribeye into steak au poivre with a creamy white wine sauce that is a reduction of chicken stock. 60 to 70% of your dish, the sauce. When you sit outside and then you can see the blue sky that is existing almost like 350 days in the year, and then you can drink that coffee from Italy, and then you can eat that pastries from France. It's pretty amazing that, you know, things can be moved so far, but without affecting anything else around, just because it's free. You know, this is the, I think, the world that we are in now.
So how did you find Merci?
It's in a strip mall next to a fast food restaurant, next to an electronics store. You would never expect. So I work at the hospital that's nearby.
Okay.
Stopped in one day and said to myself, what a beautiful restaurant. Where did this come from? Who are these people? It's romantic, but it's modern and it's clean and it's fun, and you're drawn in by the pastry case. And then once you've had the food, you'll go back again and again.
And again and again. So what did you start with? What's your go-to? This is your go-to place.
This is my go-to place. It's great for lunch, but also for dinner. They're only open certain days for dinner, so that is something to be known. You kind of get sad and if you really want it, they're not open. But I started out with the goat cheese and spinach quiche, and it was delicious. The crust to the quiche wasn't soggy. The pastry was perfect, and it comes with a little side salad, and they do a homemade ranch dressing.
That salad was something that was special. Like,
right?
I did enjoy that, and the dressing that was on that, and like you said, it's kind of a ranchy feel to it, but it's better than that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and you could tell it's definitely not something that's just poured on it from, you know, the refrigerator. Like, they made that in-house, and it was fantastic. But I had the creamy mushroom soup to kind of start off. Every single spoon I pulled out had mushroom in it. It was just dense with mushroom. It was very rich tasting, very creamy, and very good.
It's classic French, creamy mushroom soup,
yeah.
Really awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I went with another French tradition. I went with the French onion soup, and I had kind of mixed feelings about it. The cheese had mostly kind of melted to the bottom, and the crouton was a little more soggy than I would like. I will say the broth was probably the best broth I've ever had.
Yeah.
So I was just wowed by that, and just wanted to drink it out of the bowl.
Well, it can happen when you have made that soup 100 times, and just sometimes between the perfect in the kitchen and by the time it gets to your table, it can drop. And because the cheese is so tight and so gummy, you know, it will stick. But it can happen. At least the broth was delish.
Oh,
right?
It was.
Yeah. Well, what did you have for entree?
So my husband and I kind of split a burger. And I also had...
I think it's called Le Hamburger.
Le Hamburger.
Lamburger.
And I also had a little kind of open-faced brie walnut sandwich.
Oh.
They don't skimp on ingredients. The brie was thick, melted, a little bit of walnut. I think it had a little bit of honey on it. It was so much food. We couldn't finish it all. It was delicious. My husband's burger was... It's simple. The beef has all of the flavor. It's well-seasoned. It's...
anything on it special?
No, he's a very simple guy.
So he goes straight up.
Very straight up. Don't mess around with the burger. And the fries, I don't know if anybody tried any of their French fries. They have a little bit of, I want to say herb, almost like a pesto just on the top. And they are almost shoestring style, and you can't stop eating them.
Wow. Well, that style, that shoestring is pommes frites.
That's absolutely.
So it's actual, you know, French fries, right?
Right. Exactly.
The real stuff. What else did you do?
Well, I was kind of torn. I thought I might want to do something a little more traditional French, like a croque-monsieur or something like that. But instead, I decided to go with a special, which was a lobster seafood sandwich. And I came on this great baguette. It was just chock full of seafood. And it was a very light like mayonnaise-based sauce that was on it. So it wasn't heavy, it wasn't too creamy. I did notice a little bit of melted butter in the baguette, mm-hmm. which just made it perfect. I mean, it reminded me, just that bread reminded me of being in Paris.
And Jim, what did you have for entree?
I had an open-faced sandwich. The bread was fantastic. I mean, it had that crispy rim on the outside, really soft on the inside, and then layered on that was a pesto. Then they layered a sliced chicken on top of that. There was avocado, cheese, and bacon, and it was just magnificent. It was tasty in every way.
All good things.
It was, and it also came with that sweet little side salad too with the ranch again. So I had two little side salads that I ate throughout the meal.
So, Elisa, for something sweet, I mean, it's a French cafe. What did you go for?
Well, that pastry case was just amazing. I wanted every one, and I couldn't decide which. So I completely went the other direction, and I got a package of macarons to go. And they were the seasonal. So it was like a red velvet, a pumpkin, maybe a mocha.
I've never had that.
Oh, and they were delicious. They were just perfect.
I had the chef special. It was like a puff pastry swan. It was very elegant looking, and it was filled with like a beautiful thick pastry cream, but it was lighter, like it had been whipped.
Yes.
And there was like a swan that was all made out of puff pastry, and it had a lot of flavor to it.
Well, it sounds great, and they make that creme pâtissier a little lighter by folding a little whipped cream in it. You can do that at home, unsweetened whipped cream. Try it. It works. If you would like to try Merci, reservations are accepted, and the average tab for dinner is $28 without drinks.